Welcome to Highway 89, Utah's most scenic musical byway. I'm Bruce Seeley. Today we're not in our usual location. We've left our performance studio at BYU Broadcasting and traveled a mile and a half south to the home of Liz and Andrew Maxfield for a Highway 89 house concert. Right now, I'm seated in the Maxfields' music room, a one-of-a-kind space. We have here a wall of organ pipes imported from Germany, and next to that, a 1930s Knobig grand piano. We also have an audience today, and so I expect there'll be some applause in this performance. That's another change for Highway 89. But most importantly, we have Laura Cortese here to perform, along with her talented musical comrade, Mariel Vandersteel. Laura Cortese is a singer, songwriter, and one mean fiddle player. She only plays mean fiddles. She's concertized across the United States as well as overseas in the United Kingdom and Spain and Ireland and Denmark. She's appeared with Band of Horses at Carnegie Hall, Pete Seeger at the Newport Folk Festival, and Patterson Hood and Michael Franti for Seeger's 90th birthday celebration. That was at Madison Square Garden. Her latest CD is titled Into the Dark, and we'll be talking with Laura throughout the next hour. But first, let's hear some music. For our Highway 89 house concert, this is Laura Cortese and Mariel Vandersteel performing Train on the Island and then Greasy Coat.
For the best, me and my love. train on the island. Thought I heard it squeal. Running till my true love, I can't hold the wheel. Running till my true love, I can't hold the wheel. Running till my true love, I can't hold the wheel. Said, running till my true love, I can't hold the wheel. Running till my true love, I can't hold the wheel.
That was Greasy Coat, and before that, Train on the Island, performed live by Laura Cortese and Mariel Vandersteel. I'm Bruce Seeley, and you're listening to a special house concert edition of Highway 89. Now, Laura's going to talk to us for a minute. I mentioned your album, Into the Dark, and I want to talk about that, but before that, I want you to talk a little about, if we will, about the role of friendship in your music making, because we can see that right here, right now.
Right now,
tell
yeah.
us about that.
Well, yes, the reason I play music is really just for friends. I grew up going to fiddle camp, but before fiddle camp, there was classical string orchestra in, like, you know, age four, five. I mean, fourth and fifth grade, not age. Wow, I was not. No, I started at nine. So it was kind of boring looking at a music stand all the time. So when I first got to go to fiddle camp and you kind of sat haphazardly in a room and someone played a phrase and you played it back. And then when you got tired of making music, you went to the pool and played water basketball with all of the other teenagers. That was really much more my speed. And in order to be a part of that fiddling community, I had to get better at the fiddle. So that is really, friendship is it, in fact. It's primary, music is secondary.
So that was your motivation, your main motivation. And you know, though, a lot of artists are not really comfortable with the, say, being a collaborative kind of a performer, but it seems like you kind of have to be.
Yeah, no, it drives me. We actually listened on our drive here. I can't remember who the artist was, but who was they were one of the artists that does all that very cool looping stuff. And the crux of the interview was how independent and solo and not with other people that she likes to be, and that's the opposite of myself.
Well, that's wonderful. Talk about Into the Dark for a minute now. A lot of musicians gathered together to make that a reality. Tell us about some of the personnel and how that came
about.
Yes,
well, I did three EPs just before I made Into the Dark that had different pockets of communities that I was a part of. And the main pocket that I drew from for Into the Dark was this fiddle camp circuit of great female musicians, one of whom is here with me today, Mariel Vandersteel, and also Natalie Haas, Brittany Haas, their sisters, Hanukkah Castle, and another cellist named Valerie Thompson. So it's all fiddles and cello, upright bass. I play a little upright bass on it, and I play viola. And then, after recording all the strings, we called up our other friends, singers, Rose Cousins, Rose Polanzani, and then, you know, we're like, oh, maybe we should have trumpet on this one, call up our buddy Dietrich Strauss, just a few dashes of some other instruments, but the strings are at the core.
Okay. Any accordion on there?
No.
Oh,
I actually
sorry.
Love the accordion and the banjo, but I think that we didn't get that on this
Next
record.
Time.
Yeah.
Okay. Wonderful. Well, this is great to have you here. Let's make you work some more, shall we?
Working.
Next, I think we have Village Green and Life is Good Blues, and both of those are on Into the Dark. Is
they
that correct?
They are, in fact.
All right. Take it away.
I was a girl on the village green. I hadn't time for daydreaming. I carried linen soft and bright. I carried secrets through the night. Walking by the houses gray, hold my breath like a statue stand, to see the ones made of silk and gold as they danced on timber from the valley below. And in the dark I would sing a song whispered low, singing for the people in the shade. Knotted hands strung like an ox, pulling logs and stones from the lowlands to the highest hill. He built their home. My father drove every nail, but I've never been inside, except on my knees to scrub the floors on which they glide. And in the dark I would sing a song whispered low, singing for the people in the shadows. Thank you. petticoats, a gloss of crocheted lace, but for a story worth being told, pen to a page, and how I wish to sit and take in the violet smell. As the music slowed, I woke from the spell, and in the dark I would sing a song, whispered low, singing for the people in the shadow. Electric power, messages you sent to my heart came from a crown of flowers. Have we danced away the hours? Come on, have we danced away the hours? Yeah, have we danced away the hours? Yeah. Have we danced away? Life is good when the band is smoking hot. The drummer drums like it's the last chance that he's got. Boats slide up the river in a string of flames. Life is good when you know he feels the same thing, yeah. When you know he feels the same thing, yeah. When you know he feels same thing, when you know he feels the same thing. Ba-ba-ba. Going soft like the dawn, tender green like the shoots of spring unfurling on the lawn. Over dam, over dam, over sea swell, have her play the devil's pawn. Cause you know he'd do the same thing, yeah. You know he'd do the same thing. Come on, you know he'd do the same thing. Yeah, you know he'd do the same thing.
We've just heard the Life is Good Blues with an audience participation, a little choir here at the moment. Choir. Yeah, before that we heard Village Green performed live on this special house concert edition of Highway 89. I'm Bruce Seeley, visiting today with Laura Cortese in the music room of Liz and Andrew Maxfield's home, right near the Classical 89 studios, but not in them. Now, Laura, I know that you have a violin, and sometimes you have a fiddle, and is that really just depends on how you play it? Do you think about it that way?
I basically think the words are interchangeable. Yes. I once had a a wonderful violin maker, repair man, who said to me, like, the terms are the same. Every language has a word that actually sounds much like fiddle, and it wasn't until classical music became sort of a chic thing, and so the Italian violino became the preferred word. But so to me, fiddle is what you say when you're doing like music that you might want people to sing along, music that's community-based, and violin might be more, you know, sit with your hands in your lap sort of situation.
So what is it when it's a viola?
What is it when it's a viola? Deeper, lower, something like your voice.
Okay. Good. Now, folks on the radio can't see, but you play the viola in a different way.
Yes, I was plucking it sort of like a guitar. I held it to the side.
Yes. Explain that.
Yeah. I don't know why I do that exactly, other than I have found, especially playing fiddle and singing at the same time, people often walk in and say, oh my goodness, I've never seen anyone do that before, instead of listening to the song or the lyrics or the emotion that you're trying to convey. And so in as many cases as possible, I try to get the violin as low as I can and sort of out of the way so it doesn't separate me from the people I'm trying to create a sort of circuit and a community relationship with.
And because the viola is bigger, when did you decide to?
I do it on the violin as well.
Oh, do you?
I do. I do the little sideways plucking, and it's like a ukulele or a guitar. Yeah, you know, four string sideways situation.
And as you saw here, it probably encourages the audience to sing along better.
I hope so.
Yeah. Okay, that's wonderful. Well, you said you started when you were about nine. And you told us something about your camps. Is there another little story you want to share from
about
your musical history?
My musical history? Well, yeah. I went to Berklee College of Music, which is also where Liz went and Mariel also went, who's playing here with me today. So that's exciting. We're all alumni. I think fiddle camp is the biggest thing to share, the biggest reason I play music. That's where I met Mariel and where I decided that music might be something worth committing most of my life to. You know, age 15 on, I was determined to do this. So
that's great, and we're really glad to have you here. We should maybe explain, Marielle's not on microphone to talk to us. We're hearing from her in vocals, and she is here and very important part of the
performance. She's got a big presence. She's wearing a beautiful red dress.
Very much so, yes.
You can imagine that.
That looks way better on the radio. All right. Shall we do some more music?
Yeah.
Let's do that. I think Take Your Time is next. Is that right?
Yes, that is right.
All right. Here we have then Laura Cortese and Mariel performing for us Take Your Time.
Covers by morning light, you say, let's stay wrapped up tight. Oh, but I've got a list to write. The clock tick tock. Into the sea. supper by the moon. You say, let's dance to one more tune. To do the clock, tick tock, ooh, tick tock, ooh, tick tock. Take your time with me.
That's called Take Your Time. I'm Bruce Seeley, and you're listening to a special house concert edition of Highway 89 on BYU Radio. Laura Cortese, as she said, attended Berklee College of Music in Boston. She sings, she writes songs, she plays the fiddle. She's been featured in the American Songwriter magazine, and she's currently on tour in the Western United States. That means that to get here, you had quite a drive. And it wasn't a straight road.
No, it wasn't a straight road. In fact, we went Ithaca, Rochester, Chicago, Madison, Minneapolis, Santa Fe, Denver, and here we are in Provo.
Yeah, that's my goodness. And you had a concert in Santa Fe.
We did. Yeah, every place I just mentioned, we played a concert, at least one. And in Minneapolis, we played two.
Well, and you've got more to go. So this is very nice.
Yeah, the whole West Coast, L.A. to Vancouver, British Columbia.
Well, now, can I ask you where Matt is while you're doing this tour?
Yes.
Am I allowed to ask that?
Yeah, you are. He's in Boston.
Matt is your husband.
He is my husband. He's actually recording an album of a very good friend of mine, my dearest friend in the world, Hanukkah Castle, who was my maid of honor, and she is a great fiddler. She plays on my album, and she's making her newest album right now. And he's a great recording engineer, and they're in the studio.
Now, the wedding was wonderful. In fact, so wonderful that you've put a video online.
Someone else put a video online. I'm just going to put it out there that Facebook, it's all there for everyone to see on Facebook, but I didn't post a single one. It was nice. It was documented by all of my dear friends.
Now, there's a part where everybody comes filing out after the ceremony.
Yes.
And they're playing.
They are, yes.
And they don't stop while they're going out.
No, that was our recessional, was our friends. They all just like popped up. They were sort of sitting on a hillside in New Hampshire, beautiful hillside overlooking out on some mountains. And they just had their instruments all there sitting with them during the ceremony. And as soon as it was over, they popped up and played and marched us to the cocktail hour.
Is that collaborative thing again?
It is.
Yes,
it is.
That's wonderful.
And all our friends were the musicians for the band all night. So
now, did I see someone actually carrying a cello in that?
Oh, and a bass. Yeah, yeah.
How do they do that?
You'll have to watch the video.
Over again. It is fun to watch the bass go by, but I know you can put a wheel on that anyway. Well, that's great. It's wonderful you just have so much fun doing this.
I do.
I don't know if that's fair.
It's hard work. Is hard work, so it's fair. I spend a lot of time on the computer, believe it or not, like most people in their office buildings, only I'm usually in my kitchen or in a hotel room or in a friend's kitchen, organizing these crazy places all the way across the country. And there's a team of great people that help me. I have a manager, Eva Rosenberg, and Mariel does a lot of helping with that. And then we get to get in the van and do these epic drives. But at each state line, we get to take a ridiculous photo with the, you know, welcome to Utah or whatever sign. You should go check it out. Those photos are you on Instagram?
Well, great music is a lot of fun. It is a lot of work, but it's a lot of fun, and we're sure having fun here on Highway 89 with you right now. It looks like we're going to get to, here we go. This is Heel to Toe.
It is.
All right.
It's Here the most epic of all sing-alongs.
All right. On Highway 89, Laura Cortese and Mariel Vandersteel, Heel to Toe.
Mama's been tired. She ain't slept in a week. Baby's been crying. All night, squeak, squeak, squeak. I'm fine. I ain't got nowhere to go except downtown to dance that heel to toe. And Daddy's been quiet. He don't talk to anyone. He got things to do. And things never do get done. I'm fine. I ain't got nowhere to go except downtown to dance that heel to toe.
Here we go.
That old heel to toe. Heel to toe. Keep on dancing that old heel to toe.
Now one time for you.
That old heel to toe.
Yeah.
Heel to toe.
You got it.
Keep on dancing that old heel to toe. Brother's no good. Since his true love walked away, he just stays inside. And you don't come out all day. Well, I'm fine. I ain't got nowhere to go except downtown to dance that heel to toe. And sister, she's a sight. I catch her staring at the door. She used to talk about dreams. Now she don't dream much anymore. I'm fine. I ain't got nowhere to go except downtown to dance that heel to toe.
Here we go.
That old heel to toe.
Yeah.
Heel to toe. Keep on dancing that old heel to toe.
Come on, Mar.
Get you cold and put those things away. We've been down so long, been like forever and a day. Well, what might happen? Well, you never ever know if you go downtown to dance that heel to toe.
Come on,
that old heel to toe, heel to toe. Keep on dancing that old heel to toe. That old heel to toe, heel to toe. Keep on dancing that old heel to toe, yeah.
That is Heel to Toe, performed live by Laura Cortese and Mariel Vandersteel. And that concludes our special Highway 89, a house concert today. And we thank you so much for being here. Laura's a singer, a songwriter, composer. She fiddles, she plays viola and bass, and she's concertized across the U.S. and abroad, and in the U.K. and Spain and Ireland and Denmark and probably wherever else there is. She'll go there eventually. She's appeared with Pete Seeger at the Newport Folk Festival, with a band of horses at Carnegie Hall, with Patterson Hood and Michael Franti for Seeger's 90th birthday celebration in Madison Square Garden. And her latest album is Into the Dark. It's been called a fiddle-drenched Americana gem. And several of the songs she performed today can be heard on that album. More information about Laura Cortese, her tour schedule, Past projects can be found on her website. This is lauracortese.com.
You got it right.
Thank you for being here, and what an enjoyable time.
Thank you so much for having me.
Both of us, all of us. It's been really nice. And Mariel, who hasn't said anything, has certainly been here and has participated. It's been great, and we wish you success on the rest of your tour.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
We also want to thank Liz and Andrew Maxfield for opening up their home to us. And of course, they're fortunate to have this one-of-a-kind music room, and they have arranged this performance for us tonight as well. We always like to hear from our listeners, and we welcome your comments and your questions about this show. And to contact us, simply send an email to highway89@byu.edu. Highway 89 is a production of BYU Broadcasting in Provo, Utah. The recording engineer is Mark Waite. The show's producer is Jackie Tataishi. I'm Bruce Seeley. Thanks for listening.